Now, despite the Philippine government's ban on religious gatherings, the Archdiocese of Manila is standing firm on its decision to push through with its Holy Week activities. In a letter released by the Archdiocese of Manila Tuesday, Bishop Broderick Babilio said that Catholic churches will be open at up to 10% of their capacity. This comes as the Interagency Task Force on COVID-19 recently prohibited mass gatherings in all areas under the so-called NCR Plus bubble from March 22nd until April 4th, Easter Sunday. Malacañang is also now warning Bishop Abilio against encouraging the public to disobey the IATF's rules.
That would be contrary to the decision of the IATF. So we understand po that this is Holy Week. I hope the bishop will not encourage non-compliance po with this IATF decision. Ang defiance po ng IATF resolution is not covered by separation of church and state. In the exercise of police powers, we can order the churches closed. Wag sana pong dumating doon, Bishop Abilio.
But on Radio Veritas, however, Babilio argued that the rules were made unilaterally with no consultations from the religious sect. He also believes that the rules violate religious freedom.
So diyan mali na sila. At hindi dapat tayo sumunod sa ganyang pamamalakad na walang konsultasyon at it somehow breaks the separation of church and state. Mm-hmm. Sila na lang se-separate ngayon. Kaya tuloy tayo sa ating activities.
The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines backs the Archdiocese of Manila's move to open Catholic churches at up to 10% capacity this Holy Week. The CBCP's spokesperson, Father Jerome Ceciliano, described the Interagency Task Force's guidelines on churches as inconsistent and unreasonable.
Nakikita na kasi dito na it's Holy Week and then people may be needing spiritual activities, spiritual sustenance. Kaya yung tao ay welcome sa simbahan pero hindi naman niya in-encourage sa pumunta kayo ng simbahan. In fact, kung talagang yung need ng tao ay pumunta ng simbahan, si Bishop nang nabigay ng limit. Hindi natin pwedeng papasukin sa simbahan yung sumobra ng 10% because we also have to be very careful. There's a risk of the transmission of coronavirus. That's why we cannot do that.
Meanwhile, the Integrated Bar of the Philippines says that the constitutional provision on the separation of church and state cannot be invoked since the issue is a health concern and not a legal one. The IBP's president, Attorney Domingo Cayosa, is now calling on both parties to hold dialogue so that they don't end up clashing with each other.
Yung simbahan at mga kaparian kasama mga maobispo, hindi naman, they are also citizens of the Republic. At ang sitwasyon ngayon is a health pandemic. So lahat ho damay dito. It is a reasonable policy naman or rule under the present circumstances. So mukhang wala akong nakikitang conflict of separation of church and state.